I'm not the first person to prophesy about the death of somebody, and he comes to die. It has been prophesied many times. Yes, 2 Kings chapter 20, verse 1. The Bible says, in those days, Hezekiah became ill and was at the point of death. The prophet Isaiah, son of Amos, went to him and said, this is what the Lord says, put your house in order, because you are going to die. At some point, they will tell me, no, pick first. The first one, the thing I was going to pick, it is number one. So they were afraid. They started to say, oh, you guys, you are using some powers, magic. But there are those who believe, they came for prayers. It was just like that.
Yeah.
And by then, I had not even started my ministry. So I wanted really to know the prophetic and to know how it works. So I was looking in Kenya to see if there is any prophet who can help me. I tried to go to a few churches, but I realized what they were doing as a prophetic, it was not a prophetic. It was just gimmicks. So I traveled and I went to Nigeria. I think that's where people see that. That's where my accent is coming from.
I knew there must be something.
Yes. So I went to Nigeria and I met this man of God. Although he's late, he's not live right now. His name is...
The prophecy that you made about Alan Kiuna, Bishop Alan Kiuna, maybe most of the people may be asking, did prophet attend the burial? Maybe he reach out to the concerned members, if I hurt you guys, Poleni, something. Can you share with us your best, we can say it, your biggest prophecy that you ever made and it came to pass?
There are so many prophecies that I've prophesied to individuals.
Welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Martin Dean. Welcome to today's episode. And of course, guys, today, if you see me in church, I just know that I'm bringing for you something better, something educative. And of course, I'm here with one of your favorite prophets, Israel. You know, I like addressing people of God in a different way.
Amen.
So I've had, guys, if it is to be patient, I've been patient today just to feature this particular man of God in this particular channel.
Amen.
So guys, we shall be talking about 1-3 things. Amekuwa prophet kwa mtandao sana, na nikasema lazima leo nifike kwa kanisa yake atupatie 1-3. So atakuwa tunasalimia alafu from there tumalize. Prophet,
yes.
How are you?
I'm fine.
God is good.
God is good all the time.
All the time.
God is good.
And I've enjoyed the service.
Wow, glory be to God. I'm happy to have you here. And I want to commend you that you have really been patient. There are very few people who have this gift of being patient. And normally it is this patience that takes people to next level, to their promotion.
Exactly.
So we thank God for having you also in our church today.
Yeah. Thank you. I've enjoyed the service. Of course, the sermon was so good and it touched me somehow because, you know, it's something that that is happening each and every particular life.
Wow. Glory be to God.
Yeah.
Yeah, I want to welcome you once again because when we stand to teach, we teach people reality, what happens in our daily lives. And it is through this teaching that God comes down now to do his work.
Exactly.
Amen.
So let's just introduce yourself to my audience. We know I've said your name, but now your yes. Profession, what you're doing.
Yes. My name is Prophet Matthew Israel. I'm a father of 4 children. I have 1 boy and I have 3 girls. I think my firstborn is 15 years old. He'll be turning 16 years this October. And we bless God because of that. Married to 1 wife. I want to thank God for this journey because I am coming from a medical field.
Wow.
Yes, I'm from a medical profession. I get to know Jesus just a few years ago. I got born again, I think in 2014. That's when I gave my life to Jesus. And God was calling me into the prophetic. There were things I was seeing, but I was not understanding. So I just gave my life to Jesus. Initially, I think it was in Deliverance Church here in Mwiki. That's where I used to go. Until now, I wanted to know more about my calling and my gifts. And I had to join another Pentecostal church in town, which I will not mention the name.
Yeah, yeah.
So I used to minister there. I became a pastor in that ministry. Till 2020, when we had COVID, I said that now I think enough is enough. I want to go and work for God. So we came and started our ministry in 2020. But unfortunately, there was COVID-19, and at some point, no churches were shut down. So I can say in 2021, that's where we started our ministry. And we, in our ministry, because it's a prophetic ministry, God has been using us to reveal many things. By then, I think we didn't have media. So just in 2022, that's when we went full blast onto YouTube and Facebook, so that anytime we have a message from God, we can now be possible to, it can be possible to post them on our social networks. Yes.
Now, getting back to your ministry, we can see that you have a nice place, a very organized place, and a very good management.
Yes.
Tell us, when was this, maybe, how did you come up to come out with this particular building of God?
What happened is that we actually 2 months old now.
Wow.
Yeah, we've been having another structure that we just moved from. So there's a friend of mine who used to be here. Yeah, he started started building, though it was not complete, but because he was moving to other places, we came in, we occupied, and we did the decoration and the completion of the house of God. Yes.
Now, Prophet Matthew, are you from Kenya or are you from Nigeria? Because accent speaks much that of Nigeria.
I have no roots in Nigeria.
Uh-huh.
Yes, I am just a Kenyan. Mimi ni Mkenya. Mimi ni Mkenya, naezaongea Kiswahili vizuri sana. Naezaongea lugha ya Kiswahili vizuri, lakini mimi ni Mkenya, nimezaliwa hapa, nimelelewa hapa. Nimeenda shule hapa. In fact, I went to school in the village. Yes, I am born from Kakamega. Yes, yes.
You are not from Nigeria.
No, I'm not from Nigeria. I'm not Ogao. Yes, yes.
Okay.
I was born in Kakamega. I was born in a small village there called Masinga, a village that nobody knows.
I've been there.
You've been there?
Yes.
Okay, that's good. That's great. So that's where I was born. I went to school there in those village school, both in primary and secondary school. So it was in high school when I passed my... It was secondary, not high school.
Mm-hmm.
When I passed my exams, and I was told that you are supposed to join a university. So I went and joined one of the universities in Kenya, where I studied. After I had studied, I've worked with different places. I've been in Russia Hospital. By then it was Russia. That is New Nyanza Provincial Hospital. That is in Kisumu. I have worked at Coast General Hospital. I've been working with quite a number of pharmaceutical companies. I worked with Medicel Kenya Limited. I've worked with Europa. That was my last company when I resigned as a district sales manager. And then that's when the calling was too strong on me. I decided to go into ministry.
Wow.
Yes, yes.
Here you are.
Yeah.
And when did you discover that I can do prophecies and they come to pass?
Okay, what used to, this thing started at the age of 7 years. I saw angels. I had gone to take care of my father's flock, and I saw three people walk to me. And when they walked to me, they spoke to me. But after they spoke to me, they just vanished. I didn't know they were angels. So the things they spoke to me, after like 1 year, they came to pass. I saw them coming to pass in my family. But still, I was a young man. I didn't understand. I came to realize about the issue of angels, I think like 5 years ago, that they were angels, because they just disappeared, and it was very scary. I could also dream. When I dream, they will come to pass. And I'll be asking myself, where did I see this thing? Because this thing looks familiar. What is happening right now? I have seen it somewhere else. Then I would remember that it was in my dreams that I saw this thing, and it is coming to pass. So in my place of work, where I was working, my recent place of work, there are things that I would speak, and they will come to pass.
Yeah.
Particularly, I've worked in the sales department. I will tell them that this is what is going to happen. These are the targets we're going to meet this month, and they will just come to pass, just like that.
Wow.
So I remember it was this particular day. We were having this thing called chama. You know, Kenyans, they like so much. So in our company, we used to have chama, and we would pick these numbers. you pick them, these numbers to see who will be number one, number two, number three, number four. And I will just sit, I will tell them mine is number one. And they will be like, how do you're going to pick number one? So what will happen is that I will just tell everyone to pick his number, they will leave number one. And I will pick it and it will be number one. I was telling my prophet, when I say thing, it comes to pass. Because how do you know a true prophet? When they speak and it comes to pass.
Yeah,
yes. Because if you are a prophet, God anoints you. God anoints you, and once you've been anointed, when you speak, God will never allow the words of the prophet to fall on the ground. At some point, they will tell me, no, pick first. The first one, the thing I was going to pick, it is number one. So they were afraid. They started to say, oh, you guys are using some magic. Powers, magic. But there are those who believed, they came for prayers. It was just like that.
Yeah.
And by then, I had not even started my ministry. So I wanted really to know the prophetic and to know how it works. So I was looking in Kenya to see if there is any prophet who can help me. I tried to go to a few churches, but I realized what they were doing as a prophetic, it was not a prophetic. It was just gimmicks. So I traveled and I went to Nigeria. I think that's where people see that. That's where my accent is coming from.
I knew there must be something.
Yes. So I went to Nigeria and I met this man of God, although he's late, he's not live right now. His name is T.B. Joshua. When he prayed for me and he told me, you are a prophet, and he anointed me. So that's how I came. And in 2017, I tried to do ministry. But when I started the church, I received very strong resistance and opposition. So I just woke up and I realized the church had been vandalized, instrument has been taken, and that is what happened. Yes, so a few members, it was after 5 months, a few members came together. They said, no, let us build the church again. So we built. On Friday, we were supposed to launch the church with a Friday kesha. So wakati liingia tu pale kwa kanisa, what happened is that the police came from nowhere and we were arrested. So we went to Lipeleko hapa Kasarani police station. We were there for 3 days. No any judgment. Tukatolewa, nikaambiwa tu kwamba usijaribu kuenda kuweka kanisa hapo tena. Kuna pastors wamesema ukipata hapo utakumaliza. Because the church was growing very fast.
Yeah.
You know, one thing with the prophetic is that the prophetic comes with power. And anywhere there is a prophet, the church grows like a wildfire. Yes, because people have the prophetic, and if you have a prophetic, you have the prophetic with the solution, not just telling people, giving people hopes and there's no solution. Because God has really, if you want to know a true prophet, a prophet who speaks, it comes to pass. A prophet that when he's praying for you, there's demonstration of power, because every prophet comes with power. Yes. So that is where my roots are coming from. I went to Nigeria and I was told that, but I was told not to go and start a church now.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, I was told to wait first until God will speak.
Mm-hmm.
So I waited until God spoke to me in 2020. That's when now I decided to go into ministry.
Yeah.
Yes.
Now, can you share with us your best, we can say it, your biggest prophecy that you ever made and it came to pass?
There are so many prophecies that I've prophesied to individuals. I prophesied to the nation. There are things that God has been showing me, even concerning other nations. But God spoke to me, told me, you should never talk about the outside nation until now. I give you permission to start prophesying about outside nation. But he has given me authority to talk about Kenya and the individuals. So I remember I talked about President Ruto becoming the president.
Yeah.
I prophesied about it, and it came to pass. And after they came to pass, there was when President Ruto was coming to power, there was a lot of problems financially. The economy was not doing well. And I prophesied again. I said that God was going to open a door for Kenya. And we are going to have international doors. That now, even the nation that had refused to give financial help to Kenya was going to open up. And then after a while, just a few months, the president came and he said now the doors had been opened. Even those financial institutions that could not help them by giving out money, they are now open and they are giving the money, even locally. It came to pass. I spoke about last year, I think it was in 2023, prophecies for the new year. I said that we need to pray for number one, who is the president and his deputy, because I saw a disagreement. And we prayed, but sometimes God will bring a sign to make the word of the prophet to come and pass. There was a disagreement. I said we were going to have a very strong contest of words. And that's what happened, exactly happens. And I said heaven will intervene and there will be calmness everywhere.
Yeah.
Like you can see right now there is calmness.
Yeah,
you can't even know that. And then the latest prophecy, the one I spoke about last year, they are saying 7 months ago, but I had released it, I think, in the month of September, around September there. I saw a revolt where the youth were going to go on the street. And if care was not going to be taken, we were going to have a revolution. That's what I saw. And I spoke about it. And I said this time around, we are not going to have opposition leader. Because that's what God showed me exactly what was going to happen. And it has come to pass. I think that is the prophecy that went viral. That is making people now to know that there's a prophet in Kenya. Yes, it went viral and it just blew out. And people have been calling, they have been asking, are you the one who prophesied? How did you come to know about this? Because, you know, in the prophetic, it's very strange.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yes, yes.
Okay, now... I have no words for that because you are indeed a great person of God. Eh?
Yes.
And
yes.
Getting back to prophecies, and we saw the prophecy that you made.
Yes.
That
yes.
Really impacted people at some point, and also people were getting angry. Something.
Yes.
The late bishop is called Alan Bishop. Bishop
yes,
Alan
bishop
Kiuna.
Yes,
yeah.
Yes, yes.
So there is a prophecy that you made.
Yes.
And
yes.
It came to pass.
Yes, yes.
And tell us, how was the worst side, Ama, we can say the challenging part of that particular prophecy?
Mm-hmm. What happened is that, early this year when Bishop came out of America, it was announced that the Bishop is now cancer-free. He has been healed. It was announced early this year. And he came to church at some point. He was even preaching. In fact, the last service he had, I think, is it like a month ago when he had a service, like 3 weeks ago, the man looked very strong, even though he was praying. And I saw those videos recently after I gave out my prophecy. But the Lord spoke to me, told me, this thing, you have to speak it out because I am calling home my servant. He's coming to rest. So you have to speak so that the family must know this, and also... the church must know this, because anytime we lose a man of God, sometimes that those members who are left behind discouraged. Some of them, they don't know if a man of God can die. What about us? Are we really protected? Are we safe in the hands of God? So it is something that God told me to speak about it. When I gave out that prophecy, I said that there is a bishop in Kenya who's about to go to a journey of no return. He will sleep and he will not come back. God is calling him home. That was my message. So that people will know it's God calling him. It's not that he's dying out of cancer,
yeah.
But God is calling him to go and rest. But that prophecy, I think I've received quite a number of criticism, but it is also one of the prophecies that blew out internet.
Yeah,
many people, they saw it, and it went round, and people were calling even from America, from the UK, they are calling to find out what happened. So, there are even bishops who are calling me. They are telling me, how can you prophesy and then somebody comes to die? They are telling me you are a prophet of doom. No, I told them, no, that's not what happens. Yes. Of course, let me show you a scripture here. Just one scripture and then we are going to continue. It's in the book of 2 Kings. I'm not the first person to prophesy about the death of somebody and he comes to die. It has been prophesied many times.
People really came for you.
people came for me, and they were like, how do you prophesy this kind of prophecy? And you know, most of these people, that is the prophecy, it was the first prophecy they were seeing. They have not gone through the other prophecies I've been giving. This was a prophecy that was given by Prophet Isaiah. It is in the book of 2 Kings. Yes, 2 Kings chapter 20, verse 1. The Bible says, in those days, Hezekiah became ill and was at the point of death. The prophet Isaiah, son of Amos, went to him and said, "This is what the Lord says, put your house in order, because you are going to die. You will not recover." Mm. Who was sent by God? The prophet.
The prophet.
Prophet Isaiah was sent by God to come and give a prophecy to who? To Ezekiel. That he was going to die because he was ill. So he was being told this so that he can put his house in order. Mm. So anytime God is giving out a prophecy concerning death, it's because God wants to prepare you. Mm. So that death will not just find you like that. Yes, what happened is that this was a prophecy that was given, and Ezekiel prayed. Mm. He told God, "Look at one thing that I've done that can make you to keep me and add me more years." And God had him, and God added him like 15 years. He said, you've been added 15 years. That's what happened. But it was a prophecy that was given to him by a prophet Isaiah. So anytime we prophesy, it's not that we are prophesying for people to die. We are giving them a warning. Sometimes if it's not a warning, we are telling them to put their house in order. Because there is no man who wants to be, you know, God of God, that you just die like that. If God tells you you're going to die tomorrow, today at night you work on your family, put it in order. Call a few people, tell them where you have kept this and that. Tell them, "I have this land title deed, it is here, it is here. My inheritance, I want this boy to take this, I want this to take this." You are putting your house in order. So when we prophesy about this, God wants to show you that he knows everything. Yes, and after he prophesied, 2 months later, the man passed away, and he has rested in peace. So I have received criticism, especially I have seen men of God, some of them that have called me, warning me, and some of them, I have seen them speaking on social networks. They are saying that I'm a prophet of doom. In fact, there is one father of the nation who went ahead and said I'm fake. So, you know,
I saw it,
isn't it?
Yeah.
You know, if you are calling somebody fake, I always tell people, go and check the track record. Mm. These things you have been prophesying. Even recently, I just gave a prophecy about the earthquake.
I saw it.
It did not take even 2 months. It came to pass. Mm. You know, these are the things that you have to, if you are pinning down somebody, look at the track record. What has this person been prophesying? Has he prophesied over things and they have come to pass? Yes, we have been prophesying and they have been coming to pass. So ni vile Kenya unajua hatujakuwa na ile prophetic. Watu wamezoea kwamba ukiona prophet either in Nigeria ama outside the country. So this is a new thing that is happening in Kenya.
Yeah.
So for it to be accepted, it is not going to be easy. I know that. And particularly from our fathers. Unajua our fathers, they are so much afraid that the younger generation is coming up and they are afraid of becoming irrelevant. Yes, and we really respect our fathers. We have no issue with them. We honor them. In fact, the man who was speaking about this, I've just spoken to some people that I want to go and honor him in a special way, just to appreciate the work that he's doing. Yes, because even him, I know that people are saying that what he's doing is not from God. There are people who are criticizing him.
Yeah.
So it is very bad. We are in the same body of Christ. When you stand up and you begin to criticize one another, I want to tell that we are living in days whereby the enemy of a pastor is a pastor. The enemy of a politician is a politician. The enemy of a teacher is a teacher. So that is where we are right now in the country. We are living in the country whereby people are filled with jealousy. Those who are already there, they don't want the upcoming to come there.
Exactly.
They want to suppress them. And that's why they have no generation they are going to leave behind. They have no generation. They have to raise a generation. You know what happens is that God works with generation. You remember in the wilderness, there was an assignment the children of Israel had to carry out.
Mm-hmm.
But they refused. When God sent some of them to go and see the land where they were supposed to go, they came and they said, "No, we saw the sons of Anak, the descendants. Those people are tall. We look like grasshoppers in their sight. So we are not going to that land. I don't think we are going to occupy it."
Mm-hmm.
They spoke evil concerning the land. They said the land is infertile, full of stones. We cannot occupy it. And God said, "Because you have done this thing, all of you will perish in the wilderness, and I will raise up another generation that will go." Now the Joshua and the Caleb generation that will go and occupy the land. So in every generation, God sends his servants to come and fulfill some purpose. If they are unable to fulfill, God will raise up another generation. So this is a generation that God is raising up. It's not that we have not had the prophetic in Kenya. It has been there, but it is suppressed. Any prophet, I have seen prophets who have been prophesying well, but some of them, they will graduate quickly and become bishops. They want to be called bishops so that they will not be attacked with the title of a prophet. Even though, you know, where there is original, there is also fake.
Exactly.
I'm not denying that there are fake prophets. They must be there. If you have an original 1,000 not, there is also a fake one. An original dollar is a fake. So where there is original, there must be a fake. So we also have fake who are diviners who are also doing their thing, but they are not doing the will of God. But the Bible says, by their fruits we shall know them. Yes, it is by the fruits that we produce that we are known. Yes.
Now, the prophecy that you made about Alan Kiuna, Bishop Alan Kiuna, maybe most of the people may be asking, did prophet attend the burial? Maybe he reach out to the concerned members, if I hurt you guys, Poleni, something?
No, I didn't reach them, but I was there. I was in the funeral. I was there, but I was sitting behind. I just went to attend the funeral because I know the same bishops who are throwing these arrows, they were around also. So I didn't want to be seen at the front line. In fact, I was putting on some so that people would not know me. You know, many people, when they look at my hair, it's very easy to know that I'm the one. So I attended the funeral, but I didn't want to be visible. Yes, because we are living in an era whereby the so-called bishops and the fathers of the land, they can easily kill you. Yes, this world has become so dangerous. So you have to be very careful, even the way you conduct yourself, if you are a man of God, and God maybe is trying to announce you. If people are jealous of you, they are capable of doing anything. Yes, so I've not reached out to the family, but I'm planning one of these fine days. I will go to see Mama Kathy when she has calmed down, when things are good, and I'll pray with her also. Because I also have another prophecy. If she'll be willing to accommodate me, I want to talk to her and maybe speak to her what God is saying concerning her ministry and going forward. Yes.
Maybe leaving that story behind, may you just talk to the people that Pastor, or rather Bishop Kiuna left behind, and also Mama Kathy. Just talk to them.
Okay, the people that Bishop left behind, this is an advice to you. Number one, I want you to understand that when I prophesied about your spiritual father passing away, it was not an act. It was not an act that would make him to die. God had already decided that he was going to go home. And sometimes when God is calling men home, is not what you call premature death. You see, Jesus came to this world and his ministry was only 3 years. He started his ministry when he was 30 years, and at the age of 33, he passed on. So the bishop had completed his work. When you complete your work, God will call you home.
Exactly.
There is nothing else you are doing here. Like I was preaching in my previous preaching, every man is sent with a purpose. Once you achieve your purpose, God will call you home. So this man was called home because he had achieved his purpose. He had run the race and he had finished it well. So I know that you are now there and you are not orphans. I want you to understand that there are people that Bishop has left behind. And these are people who are going to carry on the legacy of the Bishop. Mama Kathy is so much anointed, and God has manifested very, very mightily through her. And I want to assure you that you have to support her at this point in time. It is this time that Mama Kathy needs you even more than ever before. It is this time that you need to go there and support her even more than ever before. You know, I support so much the women ministry. Personally, I support women a lot. And I'm asking God to help me so that I'll be able to raise more women to preach the gospel. So I want to tell people not to desert that church, because the same anointing that was on the bishop is already resting on that woman of God. So I want you to come in and support that woman. Stand with her. She needs you people more than ever before. If you don't hold her hand, please, it is not going to be easy for her. So hold her hand. She's a good woman of God. And pray for her even more, because God will still manifest through her, and God is going to bless you. Wow. Amen.